Sister Ruth was communicating with Sister West from Alabama today. They're in camp meeting there in Millbury, Alabama, I believe it is. And Brother Parks and Brother Kevin Lloyd are their speakers. Brother Parks was delayed because of a death getting there. And then Brother Lloyd had to leave because of this accident there in his church. So their speakers are all kind of up in the air right now. So we're going to pray for their camp tonight. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Amen. That God would just move for them and give them a wonderful move of the Holy Ghost and their camp meeting. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can you pray with us tonight? Amen. Dear Jesus, Lord, we love you. God, we thank you for your help to us. Thank you for the goodness of the Lord. And God, we thank you for your blessings, your help to us. God, I ask you, Lord Jesus, let the Holy Ghost help us. Let the Spirit of the Lord help us tonight. God, I ask you, Lord, move mightily, Lord Jesus. Holy Ghost, come, take your place among your people, Lord. God, move among your people tonight, Lord Jesus. God, refresh, restore, heal, Lord God, save, Lord Jesus. God, do a miracle in someone's life tonight. God, we ask it in your name. God, we pray, Lord God, for the fellowship in Millbury, Alabama, Lord God, that you would help them right now. God, send a move of the Holy Ghost. God, touch them, Lord God. Give them a wonderful revival, a wonderful refreshing of the Holy Ghost, a wonderful outpouring of your Spirit, Lord Jesus. God, I pray, Lord God, that you do a miracle for Isaac Healy tonight. God, that you would raise him up in healing, Lord. God, give him complete recovery, we pray. God, we ask it in your name, Lord Jesus. We'll give you all the glory. We'll give you all the praise. Hallelujah. 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 All right, let's worship the Lord tonight. Give him praise. Thank him for it right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Now I am delaying. I can't find my song. Amen. 3-7, you don't have a book either. Amen. Revive us again. And if you have a book, it's 370 if you brought one with you. Amen. Amen. Why don't we just praise him tonight? Amen. Let God bless us.
Oh, we were in another chamber.
past couple weeks. Amen. We've seen people proclaiming themselves to be part of a party. Yeah. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. Amen. This is your opportunity tonight. Amen. Amen. To proclaim your allegiance. Amen. To say, yes, I'm one of them. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm in Family Camp with Sunset Hill. Amen. I'm glad to be a blood-bought Christian. Hallelujah. Blood-bought child of God. Amen. Holy Ghost filled, tongue talking. Amen. I'm glad to be one of them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. You can be seated if you'd like tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Now shout amen like you're Pentecostal.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, good presence of the Lord here tonight. Praise the Lord. Amen. There's no seat belts in these pews. We've done that on purpose. Amen. Praise God. You don't have to keep your arms and legs inside the pew. Amen. But you're welcome to rejoice and have church. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Wonderful, wonderful presence of the Lord tonight. Amen. We want Brother Newton to come and speak to you tonight. Appreciate Brother Newton and his support for Sunset Hill. And to come and stay on the grounds, being here in services and helping us out so much. Appreciate him and Sister Newton. Well, are you joining Kathy tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I'll tell you what. Brother Clifton Geller said years ago, if he just enjoyed camp meeting so much, he just drank his kids. And we could see the results. Brother George Brim brought his children to campground, and look what we got. We got, you enjoyed the benefits, amen. I'm up here tonight kind of nervous because you know what, we've been accused, preachers been accused of, you know, they want to get money out of people. And so, Brother, this is a nervous thing here. I'd rather preach than try to get money. You know how hard it is to get money out of people? Glory to God. Pretty good chore, right? Amen. But how many will help me tonight? I asked Brother George, I said, you got me a story or something? Tell me how to get money out of people. He said, just tell them, brother. But how many know it does take money to run air conditioning, and it takes money to feed people, and it just takes money to operate. How much money? Brother Brim told me about $12,000 this week. I know that parents give their kids money. And we can get money out of the kids better than we can out of the adults. But don't you think that Brother Ed McDonald and Brother Ross and we can't miss Brother Nathan tonight. I told him he'd look like a snake before he got up here tonight. I think they look real nice and they preach good, but they don't get that just to get up there. One guy said, just open your mouth and the Lord will fill it. Yeah, with hot air, somebody said. But it takes a lot of studying and a lot of digging, and we're enjoying the benefits, aren't we?
Yeah.
Aren't you enjoying? Didn't he knock it out of the park last night and this morning? Wow. Amen. I was thinking about what Brother Nathan said about topping it off. I remember one time we were going through Kentucky going somewhere, and I'm kind of like that, you know. But even at McDonald's, if you supersize it, it costs a little extra. And so anyway, we were going through Kentucky, and Brother Clifton, I was trying to get a cheaper price on the gas. Some of those places, you can go a long ways before you can find a place to get gas. Especially like going down through Texas. Wow. And Sister Newton said to me, she said, the next exit, you just pull in and pay whatever price. I don't want to walk. Yes, ma'am. And I pulled in and I filled it up, and I think it was about 15 or 20 cents more on the gallon than I thought I was going to say. But life doesn't have to do with money, right? Jesus spoke a lot about money, so don't look too bad at me tonight, because we do need some money. And we don't have spaghetti suppers or pie suppers. One time we did a
a candy fund at our church, and I had to buy most of the candy. So we don't do that. I don't know if you do it here or not, but we just find out that people love God and give. That's the best source, and God wants to bless you. He said, give, and he will give it. Amen. Again, pressed down, shaken together, heaped up, running over. He said, I'll cause men to give to you. I remember times when we'd have a building fund at our church, and way back there, and it was pretty pricey. And one of the fellows who'd led to the Lord stepped up and said, don't worry about it. He called me Reverend. He said, Reverend, don't worry about that. I'll take care of it. When they come time, it was $17,200 bucks. He wrote a check out and said, whoo! You can say amen to stuff like that. But look, we're not looking for that kind of big stuff tonight. I guess not. But we're just Dalton like people, right? But I tell you what, I believe God will bless us if we give, right? I don't know how this is going to turn out tonight, but you know at home it costs money. So I don't want to kill anything tonight. I want y'all to just come on in here. But giving is such a blessing to give when somebody gives to you. But if I want to plant a garden, you know, I want to go down, I want to get some good seed, and I want to get some good plants. And so tonight, why don't you just stand up? There's no seat belts, Brother Dave said. And reach down there somewhere. My wife and I, we pulled our travel trailer in here in the mud that last Thursday morning. And we set it up in the mud, Brother Gallagher. We went to big camp meeting. We've been coming here since 1971. How long is that? 45 years? How many, brother? 45 years. Y'all look that old? No, I don't look that old. It's been good, though. I mean, God has done some wonderful things. He did here last night. And God was working here last night. But Brother Shad McDonald comes all the way from the great state of Alabama. And we were in Savannah, Georgia this year, and I'm telling you what, it's quite a ways to go. That's what I need to say tonight. Or time would fail me. Right? But will you help us tonight? I mean, brother, you know, I tell our people at home, I said, you know, somebody has to be responsible. And Brother Day and Sister Brenda Brown have to be responsible, right? And Brother George told me, he said, whether we use electric or not, they keep on with the bill. So, amen, we're just telling you tonight because we know you love God's Word, right? Right? We know you love God's Word. How many love God's Word? Don't you love this kind of preaching? I'm telling you, you can't get that to Walmart or Target or wherever. He blessed me last night. Did he bless you last night, this morning? Oh, my. Well, we want them to look nice when they proclaim God's word and be able to look good and smell good and have a good countenance and be happy. You know what? And how much I've got to go here, brother? Is this all right for the day? You said to help you. I'm trying to help you. So we just come. I just come tonight just to tell you, I believe that God's people. He said, I believe it. Amen. And so, I'm going to help me out with it. Amen. Well, they got it. Now, that's not Kentucky Fried Chicken. Somebody said last night. We're not after Kentucky Fried Chicken. Offering like this before. But we really don't want to take it. We want to just receive it, and we want you to give tonight. Can we stand so you can just, you young people, you know, I know you have some change, and you know, just like you put it in there tonight, and you know, tell them what God, he might bless you with a wonderful fellow down the road. Who knows what God will do, amen? But it starts with a giving heart. Father, we thank you tonight, Lord. We thank you, God, for this place. We thank you for the ministry this week and the messages, God, that we've heard. Lord, we've reaped the spiritual. And Paul said we have a right to reap the carnal. And so tonight, Lord, you know the needs of this camp more than any of us, Lord. And God, you promised to supply our needs according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Lord, help us to give tonight. Help us to give cheerfully. Lord, I pray tonight. We just put it in your hand. We're believing in God tonight to meet the need. In Jesus' name, everybody said amen. Go ahead, brother.
Salvation. I've been saved for 63 years. let you get up. After you got standing, kept pushing you down till you got the Holy Ghost. I had to get it. Praise God. Oh, I'm glad for God. I'd like to be running so fast that I'd be 100 miles inside the gate before the devil ever knew I was there. Hallelujah! Praise God. If you'd like to have a tonight revival, give me a call.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Now, I'm not pit at deception, and that grown man was screaming like a baby, holding on to his front door, screaming. I'm talking about a storm. You ever had one? Some of you came in and you're in the middle of one. And you need to quit worrying about how you're going to look. And you need to get a hold of somebody's hand, and you need to get praying in the Holy Ghost.
parents took me on one of those horse chuck wagon horseback rides, you know, where you go out on a horseback ride and you ride out in the woods somewhere and you get a meal and then you ride back. And I don't know what happened, but somewhere along the road, my horse decided that it didn't want to stay with all the other horses. And it took off running down through the trees. Limb was smacking me across the face and limbs hit me, and I knew the only hope I had was to hold on. Amen. But it wasn't long until somebody came and caught that horse and brought it around to its senses. But all I had to do was hope, you know what? Amen. You may be in for the ride of your life, but I'm telling you, just get another grip. Amen. And hold on. Amen. God's not going to let you down.